गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज योर रिवियस इन रिवियस सोशल स्टडीज पोर्शन ओनली विल कंटिन्यू. सो नाउ टेस्ट इज ओवर एंड वी हैव टू प्रिपेयर फॉर नेक्स्ट टेस्ट, FA2 टेस्ट. ओके, सो लास्ट क्लास व्हाट वी दैट वाज नॉट पार्ट ऑफ SA1 एग्जाम, लेसन नंबर 8 आई कंप्लीटेड. हाँ, तो टुडे विल स्टार्ट विद लेसन नंबर 9. सो बिफोर आई प्रोसीड, व्हाट वी लर्नड इन दैट प्रीवियस क्लास दैट ओनली विल जस्ट डिस्कस. Lesson number 8, it was about water. So water is very important that you know what you learned about the chapter. Let's recall a little bit. So as you know, like air we breathe, without air how we cannot live, like that water is also very very important to survive. So all living things, they need water. So what is the main source of water? It is mainly rain. Other than you know, our full earth is covered by so many water bodies. But all water is not we cannot consume or we cannot drink or we use for our cooking. So very less portion, only 2% or 3% we can use. So that's why we should not waste water. Other than drinking, cooking, washing, cleaning, so many work we do. Then plants, animal, birds, they also need water. That much you understood. Then one important thing you you learned in the chapter, that is water cycle. Water cycle means what? Due to sun heat, all the water bodies, that water, it will get vaporized. Means it will become vapor. So, and it will form cloud in the sky. Means as it getting heated up now, so it will like a smoke, it will just go up and it will form clouds. Cloud is nothing but it is a bunch of water vapor. Okay, so at one time it will become very heavy. And it cannot hold all the water vapor together. It will burst and it will become rain. So due to sun's heat, all the water bodies, water, it will become vapor. It will create cloud once again. After some time, that water cloud, it will burst once again in the form of rain. That water only, once again, it will be gathered in our water bodies. So this process is going on and on, like a cycle. So that is only called water cycle. That's why there is a balance in our nature. Understood how much water is getting vaporized? Once again, it is coming back to our land or water, river, sea, all the water bodies. Once again, it is getting filled up. Understood? So that is one more thing. And knowingly or unknowingly, we pollute our water bodies. Like we throw garbage, then factories and all waste material is getting mixed up with the water. In the river, they drain and all everything. All dirty water is getting mixed up with the water. So we unknowingly or knowingly, we pollute our water. So now it is, population is growing more, water is becoming less. It is very precious. So we should try to not to pollute the water bodies. So that much you have learned in the previous class, lesson number 8. Today we proceed to lesson number 9. So what is the lesson about? It is festival. So is the word you heard, I think, Festival means what? Festivals are special days. See, normally what you do, everyday routine, what you do, getting up, work, if school was there, you end up going to school, you study, then evening once again you're going back, you play a little bit, eat, sleep, once again you come. So that's a daily routine. But few days in the year will be very special. Why, you know? Because that day, there won't be any studies, there won't be any school, it will be holidays for us and you, your relatives, you meet with your friends and all, you wear new clothes, then mommy will prepare special dish, we'll decorate our house, we clean our house. So those are special days. That will be different from normal days. So that are only called festivals. Okay. So India is a vast country. So there are so many people are living. All people there, all part of our country, a different festival we celebrate. So normally, you know, Diwali, Dasra, then Holi, then Eid, then Christmas, you know many festival names. Today we'll learn in details that why we celebrate festival and different types of festival in this lesson. Okay, so keep your book open, that social studies part, page number 297, page number 297, lesson number 9. It is our festival. Okay, so festival are special days, I told. Now, normally, so far you know national festival, religious festival, two types of festival you learn. But now you're in little bit higher class, third standard, you know more about harvest festival. That is very important. Why I tell you? See, our population, India is a very big country. Because so many people are living here. They need food. So who is providing us food? Like if you go to market, you ready made, you are getting fruits, vegetables, all grains. Then anything you name it, leafy vegetables. So everything you are getting ready made. But who is growing that for so many people? So much food and all. Who is growing? Our farmers. So most of the people, no, in villages and all, they depend on this work, means agriculture work. Okay, so see, 2-3 months they will hard work, then to grow some crops, how much hard work is there back of it? Can you imagine? They from putting the seed to last when they are getting the crops. So they have there are a lot of hard work, lot of patience. So what they do, no, farmers, when it is harvest time, means harvest. Now see here, three types of festivals are there: harvest festival, national festival, religious festival. We'll discuss now harvest festival. It is related to agriculture because people need to eat. So that food, who is growing? Our farmers. So farmers, what they do, they from putting seeds to until they get the full crop, they are working hard and they are working non stop. So when the crops are fully grown, it is ready to cut, that time it is called harvesting. Means they are cutting the fully grown crops, be it rice or wheat or fruit, vegetable, anything. When it is fully ready, farmers, they will cut it to sell or to for their own consumption. So that time is called harvest time. So that is very important and very happy moment for them. So that when the new crops are coming, they celebrate that with a new crop like rice or anything. They make one special dish like pongal. You know, you heard so many types of sweets they make with the new crop. So they celebrate that time. That is only called harvest festival. So in our country, all of throughout the country, like North India, you go, one festival will be the harvest festival. Then South India, you come, one festival will be. Since we are staying in South India, we know few name like Sankranti, we know Pongal, we know Onam, we know. Apart from that, Lohri, Bihu, like that, few are also there. Other parts of our country will learn today. So few harvest festival. Now you understood what is harvest festival. Harvest means that farmers, when the full crops are grown, wheat or rice or anything, so that is when the time to cut it, means it is fully ready. That time they celebrate. So new rice, they make pongal, then the sweet dish. So the sugar cane it will come, the jaggery they will get, with that they will make sweet dish. Okay, so anything new are growing, it is ready, they celebrate. Okay, so they thank God, nature, because nature means they are getting rain, sun. With that only they are able to grow the crops, is it not? So they celebrate that time. So that is called harvest festival. You understood? Now few names I wrote, you see, and every time I told you EVS time, you keep on rough note with you. So write this name first: Sankranti, then Pongal, Lohri, Onam, Bihu. So I'll tell you, Sankranti, you know, all full of South India, means like we are in Karnataka, then Tamil Nadu, Kerala. So it is coming under South India. So here it is Makar Sankranti, they say, they celebrate Sankranti, Pongal, both they will celebrate. So Sankranti, full South India, they will celebrate. I write here, see, South India. Okay. Now Pongal, normally it is very famous in Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu, Chennai. Tamil Nadu. So in your rough note, you write the points, children. Harvest festival, one is Sankranti. All over South India, means it is Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Kerala. south part of India, they will celebrate Sankranti. Pongal also celebrate full South India, but in Tamil Nadu it is very very grand. They will celebrate in Tamil Nadu Pongal. Huh? Then Lohri, I'll come now. So before that, Onam you have heard, I think. That is in Kerala. Kerala Malayalam people, they celebrate. That time boat race will they will do. Then they decorate the full house with flowers. And they special food. So many varieties they will put. Meal they will prepare. Very famous. Huh? Onam. So that is in Kerala. Kerala. Then Lohri is in Punjab. Because Punjab will supply that chapati and all you eat, no? That is made up of wheat. Other than wheat, other grains also, jowar, bajra, so many varieties, food grain will be grown there. Punjab is very famous. So there, for many people are dependent on agriculture work. So there, so many farmers, they will celebrate Lohri. It is very famous there, Punjab. It is in North India, Punjab. Bihu is northeast, means West Bengal, Assam. Assam name you heard, I know. Northeast it is, Assam. Okay, some they write SSOM or SSAM. Both are correct, Assam or Assam, they say. South India is Sankranti famous. Tamil Nadu famous for Pongal. Punjab, Lohri. Kerala, Onam. Assam, Bihu. Okay, so these are all harvest festival. For farmers, they thank nature. They, whatever the first crop coming, they make out of something, special dish. They wear new clothes and they decorate their place and they enjoy. Okay, so this much you understood. First type of festival is harvest festival. These are the few names you write in your rough note for practice, the spellings. Okay, so this much understood. Now we'll discuss national festival. So this much I rub now. Okay, finish children now. See ya. Now, national. National means it is related to nation. Means we are citizen of India. Nation means country. So we are Indians. So some days are very special for us. For that, all Indians, they will celebrate. Okay, so you can name it. First is Independence Day. First is Independence Day. Independence Day. See that spelling? Independence Day. Achha, before that, before I go to religious, first lesson page, I will little bit I read, children. See here. Lesson number 9, our festival. Main points I will read. People of India are so different from each other. You go any part, some difference should be there. Be it their language or their clothes or their cooking, food habit or appearance wise. Their face and also will be different. If you go north side, people will be very fair and their food habit also different. They eat mostly roti or something like that. They eat. But you come to south, we eat more rice. Okay. So because we grow more rice. So depending on that, people are different, all state. And they celebrate different festival. Next, religious festival. Some religious festival are celebrated by all Indians. Like harvest festival, this one. Almost all Indians, they will celebrate. Okay, so as it is in mix in your book, it is fully mixed. So I will explain on the board itself. So this much you understood, harvest festival. Now, national festival, few days are there, all Indians there celebrate. Now, what is Independence Day? You know, 200 years we were under British rule. Okay, so after 200 years, we got our independence. So that date is 15th August 1947. So every year, 15th August, we celebrate our independence. We got independence on 15th August. So every year we celebrate 15th August. This date, very important, you remember. This also you write in a book. Independence Day, when it comes, 15th August. Very important day, that is 15th August. Right, children? See the spelling. All E here. INDEPENDENCE. Independence Day. It is falling on every year 15th August we will celebrate. So, Independence Day, what we do now? Our Prime Minister, he will waste national flag. And we remember on that day, we remember our freedom fighters. See, we had to struggle so much to get our independence. Many people there sacrificed their lives. They are called freedom fighters. So we remember their sacrifice on that day. We waste our national flag. If school is open, in school also we do some function on that day. And we remember their sacrifice, Independence Day. That is one national festival. Second one, I'll tell you now, Republic Day. Republic Day. See the spelling, R-E-P-U-B-L-I-C. Republic Day. That comes on 26th January. Celebrate on 26th January. Now, Republic means what? If Republic means we are not under any king or queen, that rule. No, we are not under anybody's rule. We are we choose our leader like we do election. We choose our prime minister, our president, our leader, chief minister, governor. Okay, we choose our leader from among us. Like we people only, normal people only will become our leader. Right, so we became Republic. On this day, date was 1950. After independence only, after 2-3 years, we became Republic. Means we do election. You heard, no? So that we became Republic. So we celebrate 26 January every year, Republic Day. So this is another national festival. One more important, that is Gandhi Jayanti. Recently we celebrated Gandhi Jayanti. So, now, who is Gandhi? You heard the name. He was a great leader. So, Gandhi Jayanti, his birthday is falling on 2nd October. 2nd October. October. So, recently we celebrated his birthday as Gandhi Jayanti. Means, he was a great leader and he contributed so much for our freedom struggle. When we are struggling, no, for our freedom, he was a great leader. So his birthday, 2nd October, we celebrate every year, Gandhi Jayanti. So these are three main national festivals. Okay? Independence Day, Republic Day, and Gandhi Jayanti. He was called father of our nation because he was such a great leader. So this much you understood, children. I discussed Harvest Festival, National Festival. And now I'll go for religious festival. This is, you are very familiar because every month you are having some or other festival, is it not? So these two I discussed first. Now we'll go your favorite part, that is religious festival. So this much I will drop. There's no place. Now. Now, religious means what? Since we are so many people staying here, we follow different religion. Some are Hindus, some are Christians, some are Muslims, some are Sikh. Okay, so then some are Jain. So how, which leader they follow or which guru they follow and which religion they follow, depending on that, they also have different festivals. Okay, so that one I'll discuss now. Now, in a week, what festival is coming for us? That is Dasara. We start with Dasara. So, now Dasara means, Das means 10 days. We celebrate, huh? We celebrate 9 days actually, Navratri. Then, 10th day, it will be grand. So, Dasara means what? Some people, they tell that on this day, Lord Rama. God Rama, he just killed that demon, Ravana, on that day. So, we celebrate Dasara on that day. Okay? So, So before that, we 9 days will 1/1/1/1 special we celebrate. So that is our main Dasara. It is celebrated for 10 days to mark victory of good over evil. Means Ram was good, he was God, and Ravan was evil. So on that day, effigy means like doll, that they make out of cloth and all, and they burn it off. So like they are a symbol that evil one means bad one is getting destroyed. That's all. So Dasara means 10 day celebration. And Northeast, West Bengal, they celebrate Durga Puja. That is very grand there. Okay. So this is one, Dasara you understood. Number two, Diwali. Diwali is very, very colorful and everybody loves Diwali, is it not? Diwali day, we say normally it is festival of lights. This on that day, we decorate our house only with lights and it is very beautiful. On that day, we worship goddess Lakshmi. Lakshmi is a goddess of wealth. So normally business people, compulsory they will do, we also do. Diwali, we decorate house, we make different kind of sweets, we wear new clothes. Children, they love Diwali, is it not? Earlier used to burst cracker, but nowadays everybody became very conscious and they don't burst nowadays most because it will pollute our air. So people are becoming very understanding. They don't do now, but they decorate with lights. So Diwali is festival of lights, we can say. They put diya, colorful diya, and they do Lakshmi Puja. Okay, so Diwali. Next we'll go. So these are two main for Hindus festival. Apart from that, Eid. For Muslim people, it is Eid. What they do know, 1 month they will observe fasting. Means morning, sunrise to sunset, they won't eat anything. Night time only, one time they will eat, and they sacrifice so much. Means they won't eat, they won't drink, they give for poor people clothes, money, okay, that they will distribute. Then after 1 month fasting, Eid they will celebrate. That is their biggest festival. On that day, they will prepare semaya, their special dishes there, and varieties food they will prepare. They go to mosque, they will wear new clothes, and relatives they will come over. Here all the religious festival, they meet each other, relatives and friends, neighbors, they exchange sweets, like that. It's very happy festivals, okay? Then Eid, you understood now? Then Christians people, they have Christmas. Christmas. C-H-R-I-S-T-M-A-S. Christmas. Christmas, their God Jesus, his birthday, it is falling on 25th December. Christmas is fixed. It is every year, 25th December only, it will come. Other festivals, it will vary. That will vary. But Christmas, every year, 25th December. 25th December, they will celebrate Christmas. Okay, so this is fourth one. For Christian people, it is main festival. Other than also, Sikh people, they celebrate 10 gurus. Their 10 gurus' birthday on Guru Purab. So that is Guru Purab. One more is Guru Purab. So Sikh people, they on that day their religious holy book, that is Guru Granth Sahib, that day they will read. They will go to Gurudwara, their temple, and they take up procession also on that day. Okay, so that is one thing you understood. So Eid also. So five main I discussed as religious festival: Dasara, Diwali, Eid, Christmas, Guru Parab. Okay. Next one, Harvest Festival, I already explained. National Festival also, I explained. In a book called Mixed, so like that, on the board only I explained. And few birthday we celebrate, like Jawaharlal Nehru birthday, he was our first Prime Minister. And he was very fond of children. So his birthday we celebrate as Children's Day. That is also, in school is open, means we celebrate Children's Day. It is 14th, that is also fixed day, 14th November. It is Jawaharlal Nehru's birthday. So we celebrate as Children's Day. Children's Day. And one more, Teacher's Day. That also you're familiar with. One of our president was there, Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan. His birthday we celebrate. He was a great teacher. So his birthday we celebrate on 5th September. This is also fixed. 5th September is Teacher's Day. Yes, Teacher's Day. Teacher's Day. Okay, next one. I'll do the exercise. But before that, summary, I'll tell main points. Festivals are time of sharing and spreading happiness. Holi, Dasara, Eid, Christmas, Diwali are main religious festival. Independence Day, Republic Day, Gandhi Jayanti are national festival. Birthday of some great people are celebrated at festival. Like Gandhi Jayanti, Gautam Buddha also one religious leader. So his birthday also we celebrate Buddha Purnima, we say. Like so many festivals are there, main points we discussed. Then Ganesh Chaturthi, Easter, Navratri, Navroz, Muharram, Tees, Bihu, so many are there. Okay, so our country is full of festivals. We like to enjoy each moment, each day. Okay, so now go to 301 page, children. So this much I think you understood. You have idea, festival, little you, maybe new things you understood today. Okay, now, so I'll rub now. Page number I'll tell now, children. Page number 301. Only two exercises are there. We'll finish it up. Okay. Now, in between holidays are there, no? So one lesson I completed today. Okay. In between holidays, we'll do kind of finished portion. And it is familiar chapter for you. Festivals. You know half of the things you know already. So page number 301, you open page and do the exercise in the book itself. First one, write the name of the festival or celebration below the state, below the date, children. Okay, so first one, 14th November is 14th November. Here, see, two dates are there, and here also two dash are there. You see, in your book, page number 301, write the name of the festival below the date. What date? 14th November they have given. You write first one, Children's Day, right? Children's Day. We celebrate on 14th November. Children's Day. Because Jawaharlal Nehru was very fond of children and he was our first prime minister. So his birthday we celebrate Children's Day. This side you see 25th December they have given. I told it is Christmas. C-H-R-I-S-T-M-A-S. Christmas. Here, 2nd October is Gandhi Jayanti. Gandhi Jayanti. Write in your textbook directly, children. Don't keep it pending. 26 January, Republic Day. Republic Day. R should be capital. R-E-P-U-B-L-I-C. Republic Day. Okay, right. First one, Children's Day, down, Gandhi Jayanti, you write. This side, you write Christmas, here, Republic Day. Right. And second main is question answer, you will get in the PDF. Third main, I'll write now, match the following. So, this much finished. Rub now. Now page number 302 you see. Page number 302. Here 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 is there, children. See, I'm not writing. This side. First word is there, Sevaya. You write 3. I'm not copying, just write. First option you write, Sevaya. You write 3. Then second of word you write 1. Third word you write 5. Fourth one you write 2. And last one you write 4. Now I'll match and I'll tell you. See, Diwali, Diya. Diwali, Diyas. Raksha Bandhan, Rakhi. Eid is Sevaiya. One sweet dish. So if you write like this, you can match easily. Eid, Sevaya. Christmas, Santa Claus. To give gifts and all, no, Santa Claus will come on Christmas Day for children. Holi, colors. Holi is festival of colors. That's one religious festival. In that one, I forgot to tell you, Holi also we celebrate. That is festival of colors. So we put colors on the day, and that time, no, what happens? A few grains like wheat is very important. We make roti and all, no, wheat, different kind of grams means the dal, mustards, then millets, then all, that time it will be ready for cut, means it ready for harvesting. That is also one more harvest festival. Okay, Holi we celebrate that day. Okay, so one lesson I completed. Daily you see the class. Prepare for the next test. Okay, so notes when it will be uploaded, immediately you write it off. I hope you have written the test nicely. So next class we'll meet. Thank you, children. Have a good day.